Dear friends and former lovers, yeah, this is George Lees, the professor of neuroscience and the fraud researcher now, who is going to tell today the story of Elvis Presley's bloodline and the links to George W. Bush and seven of the Mayflower passengers. Yeah, and I'm going to tell you the story of why my wife is trying to divorce me. And all of the evidence on that, that means that she and her family, that is the Hancock's family in the Chipping Norton region and in David Cameron's constituency of Witney, they have massive homes in three locations in the south of England, and that she wants to steal mine only to silence me as a political activist. Have you heard of Elvis before? Love me tender, love me true, never let me go. Oh, my darling, I love you, and I always will. Yeah, I swore that oath, and this woman broke it. This is her mugshot now, posted yesterday on Facebook with all of the declarations on how she has tried to have me sectioned twice, yeah, between the years 2011 and 2014, and how that involves the involvement of the local police, who were coppers before they became police people. All of it is a massive scam so that me, as an activist trying to return our country to prosperity, can be banged up. I've got 2 weeks now before they take my home from me. Yeah, that letter arrived this morning. Where is it now? There it is. Yeah, Pinnacle Hill Park. It's the Pinnacle elite families, yeah, that are getting me rid of me. Yeah, and that's the Jedburgh Sheriff Court and Peter Patterson, who are totally complicit in the war crimes of Iraq, Afghanistan, and all of the profiteering of everything that I've reported. It's all over my website. Yeah, and if you go, this is the felon. No, I'm the felon who she has created out of the work, and all of her relatives have bailed out of anything on the internet. Her brother-in-law is a big man in the asset strip. Her brother, Dr. Stephen Andrew Hancock, that's him. Yeah, that is him. Dr. Stephen Andrew Hancock's OB, he issued shares worth 100 quid, yeah, him and his poofy boyfriend, Philip Georgiou, all of them have taken off all of their Facebook pages and everything that they have on the social media, because he is a crook out of Chipping Norton. Yeah, that's where Cameron has been chased out of government. He led the cabal, and all of my emails mean that he is now complicit in all of the war crimes, yeah, that Tony Blair committed even. Yeah, so 100 quid's worth of share, and that is Team Valerie. Do you get it? Yeah, that's my ex-wife, and that is her in the flesh. Yeah, looking quite seedy and a bit dim-witted. Take my word for it, that is not true. She is a very clever person. Oh, it's not going to show me the picture of Mrs. Valerie. Oh, there she is. Isn't she lovely? Yeah, she's now, for reputational reasons, a dumb blonde. Yeah, that's her nicknames on my Facebook post yesterday. As, yeah, I will section you. Yeah, and bottle blonde. Yeah, total fraud. The whole of her life, she trained with Marks and Spencers. She trained in Intel, and everywhere we went around the world, she introduced me to the MI6 and MI5 personnel. Yeah, and those videos have been posted for years, and that reveals the crimes of Butlins and the persecution of me by my neighbours, including Ronnie McElrath, who's employed by Butlins, and all of them get pathologies. Her family, that are the Salters, have massive cancers. Yeah, they're money launderers all over the world, and I've got their director numbers everywhere. And when I started to release them into the negotiations about the divorce, she suddenly became a conciliator and gave me my pension back, which they had totally threatened to take away. Okay, aliases I do, yeah, at the wedding, and asylum. Let me show you what I posted about her attempts to get me murdered by NHS, by Dr. Ian Fingland, the copper that condones the profiteering from all of his patients by giving too many drugs by volume to all of them on behalf of pharma, where I used to work, and I earned a six-figure salary, which is why she moved into my life. Yeah, kind of dumb looking. Do not believe that. Yeah, if we take a picture from the back, yeah, and we get a rear end of it, into it, I would need widescreen facilities, which Rupert Murdoch can provide, because he's our boss. Yeah, he's the boss of Police Scotland, and I'll show you all of the interlocks, even genealogically, to the relatives of Bill Gates that are the Stephen House ancestors. Right then, so let me show you what I revealed about this woman the other day on Facebook. Last night, actually. George Lees. There she is. This is my lovely ex-wife, Mrs. Valerie Jane Lees. Nay, like the donkey in the Bible, Hancocks, who when we married in 1991 said I do. She said it again in 2011 when Dr. Fingland wanted me sectioned for revealing all of the crimes of the doctors over the UK who get 40% of their six-figure salary for prescribing too many drugs to their patients, and within months of me paying off the mortgage for the house that I owned before we met. Yeah, that is 2011. Within 2 months, she was trying to section me because she knew that in law she would be entitled, if I was guilty of anything, to half of the home that I totally owned before I met the bitch. She said I'd do it again in 2015 when they asked if she could condone sectioning me for the second time or the second attempt. They did actually section me on that occasion. Okay, do you get it? She is now, and her brother, totally disappeared from the internet and the social media. Yeah, her brother runs the dental cabals all over the world, and the pair of them acid strip all of Britain's dental students using a thing called CPD, which I've exposed as a completely different financial fraud, because CPD in America is something to do with the government profiteering from the people. Okay, it's not the same continuing professional development that they use to demand that everybody who's diverted into that every year in their working life, so that they can retain the right to work by spending all of their time learning what they already know. Yeah, and that means that they can get on with their financial crimes against the people. Yeah, the relatively minor league compared to the things that I told you about the Bank of England yesterday. Let's remind you of that. Okay, so pictures. Let's get that down. And there is the Facebook pages. And here is the declaration that Elvis Presley is the ancestor of Andre Luxan Jeanette Sibbins, Lucas Andreasen, Aufen Lorenz, the husband and wife, Trente Andriez, and Jasper Hood. Yeah, the lovely freedom concept coming into the stories about the underworld. Jan Hood married Rachel Van Boonschoten. Tunis Hood married Elizabeth Harrison. John Hood married Sarah Austin. William Hood, yeah, and there are Hoods in my hometown too, totally decrepit with arthritis and other conditions, and members of the fishing club, which is stolen, yeah, which has allowed the Duke of Roxburgh, who's on the bloodlines and interlocks in the profiteering with all of the people that are Elvis's ancestors. Yeah, that is Guy Innes-Ker, who lives in Flores Castle, the Piso Joke. Yeah, that's the Kers of Cessford, and it is the Ker that is Michael Ancrum, that is the Marquis of Lothian. Yeah, and he gets covered up using the Lothian Road date rape drugs, yeah, and all of it is false news, and that is why they have disappeared off the internet, because they know that anything I know about them will be published, yeah, if they were to stay on Facebook. Yeah, William Hood married Elizabeth somebody or other. Joshua Hood married Margaret Johnson. William Hood married Mary Le Warren, the rabbit's joke, and the Delaware, Delaware namings. Minnie Mayhood married Jessica McLeod Presley. Vernon Elvis Presley married Gladys Love Smith, and Elvis Aaron Presley was the entertainer that the whole world grieved for in 1977. He died at the age of 42 because he was stressed out with public pressure. Yet, like my wife has imposed on me, I revel in it. Yet they've come and given me the 2-week threat that I get evicted from the house that I totally owned before I met the bitch. Yeah, my favourite name for her is actually the Vash, because all of it, they think they're really clever and that the citizens are really easy to dupe. Yeah. And that's because these are the survivors of all of the wars, and most of the surviving bloodlines are the people that need innocent people to sire their children. Yeah, that's why all of our children are male, and that's why the 2 miscarriages that she had, she proclaimed to have been female embryos in her womb. She proclaimed that. Okay, so do you get it? Elvis Presley, the entertainer, yeah, is related to all of this. And guess where I found it? I was looking for the Murrays of the Moravian religion that is Protestantism, and that is the Murrays that are the bandits of Philip Hoch and Fala, and those are the Fala people that become the wives, yeah, the Murrays that become the wives of the murderous FDR, yeah, who's in the bloodlines, but he's not highlighted on this set of disclosures, okay? And that is all of the disclosures of the cemetery in Selkirk. They're going to have to take the gates down and take all of their signs down, because that is FDR and Teddy's war crimes. Yeah, 45 million dead, and all of the jokes about Pearl Harbor are the residences in New York. Yeah, that is Oyster Bay and the Brooklyn area, Miss Hannah Mary Brookfield. Yeah, it is the Rothschilds what do it, and they are the people that sent the sheriff officers this morning. Yeah, the sheriff officers are called the Scott Company. Yeah, and the Scott Company is registered in Edinburgh, and I found this morning that they are funded by the Lloyd's debt pool and the Five Arrows debt pool for Rothschild. Yeah, they did not know that themselves. I found it out this morning. Right then, so let me show you some pictures of what the news is going to break today. Yeah, I hope it breaks the Camilla's back. Yeah, all of the crimes of all of those false marriages and all the bastard kids that include President Clinton in America. Yeah, the half-brother of the Queen, Winston Churchill being their father in both cases, using artificial insemination for the Queen, and that is the British-American tobacco joke. Yeah, and the use of the cigar tube for Monica Lewinsky's sexual pleasure much later in all of the false news. Okay, right then, so where shall we start? Let's start with the pictures in case I don't get through all of the tabs. Okay, there is Miss Valerie Jane Lees again, trained at Marks and Spencer's, yeah, moved on to Otago Polytechnic where her boss was a care, yeah, moved to Plexus where a boardroom member was a care. Yeah, and she has been in league with the Germans and Dieter Box companies that were the worktop manufacturers, and that is the piezo joke in Hexham, because piezo means floors and worktops. Yeah, and that, I forget what the name of the company was. Dieter Box was murdered because of his bad relations with the company in Hexham that is called, no, I can't remember it. Let's get rid of her. Yeah, not in the physical sense. She is much cleverer than she looks in that picture, take my word for it. But when I start to release the director numbers for her brother, yeah, and that's the team that tried to have me sectioned, Her brother is complicit in the war crimes. Of everything I have reported to Jedburgh Sheriff Court and Gaius Innes-Ker from Flores Castle, yet who's a relative of Elvis Presley's? Yeah, it's unbelievable. Yeah, this is the aristocracy that are the Knights of Malta. Yeah, and all of them are in league with sleazy people like Jimmy Savile. He's a Knight of Malta too. She used to go to Yorkshire, to that massive place in Scarborough where the cooks sailed from, and all of it is the series of world owning families, and she has been totally treasonous to me all the time through my life. Yeah, and my son was really young when the Lockerbie disaster happened, and you now understand that that is likely to be false news, using the Loki joke about the Norse gods, and her name is Valkyrie. Yeah, and I am in a home called Valhalla, which is the vanquished, yeah, in war. I am not giving up. I am reveling in the fight, and they are off now, all of the social media. But she wants all of her photographs back. Yeah, she can have that, and every one of them will be implicating them in financial frauds. Yeah, did you see how much the shares were worth when they were issued by her brother, OBE? Yeah, in the homosexual relationship. Through all of the time that she has deserted me, I've not been allowed to see my children, but our homosexual brother is. Right then, so let's get back to the main story of globalism. Yeah, she's a huge fan of that, whole life. Yeah, okay, so there is not the picture listings, but the picture listings are Stephen Andrew Hancock's, yeah, £274,000 profit out of a share capital release of £100. Yeah, when that went on the internet, yeah, using my nickname of Surgical Stockings, it was posted on the dental websites, yeah, where he steals from all of the customers. And what my wife does is to ring them up and get them in, dragged into that right to work CPD issue. And he runs massive, that is my wife's brother, who ran his companies using my wife as an employee in my house with my IT, which they later had encrypted using crypto wallet software, RSA. My son has witnessed that that happened, and that that was my son Archie's video. My son Archie is still his friend on Facebook, but is not mine, because he's a friend of Finland who tried to section me as the doctor twice. Once in 2011 and once in 2015. Yeah, and he actually sectioned me that year. Not seen him since. Did not even have the courage to come to the inquest with my son, who at that point, having worked with my wife in Otago Polytechnic, declared that he had had psychiatric problems himself. That is the treason issue that I warn everyone about. And it's amazing how the acts of God, yeah, afflict all of the people that pretend to be my friends and my lovers, yeah, and in the end they become my greatest deserters. That does not apply to my son. He's an intelligent man and he's courageous, yeah. And all of the sons are clever, yeah, but one of them is now involved in charitable scams in his spare time, and all of them are in the university debt pool that I am trying to save all of Britain's children from. Right then, so next one is the pictures that we've got here. So there's Elvis, yeah, you remember him? Oh, the lovely songs, yeah. And this is the most telling one. There's no earthly way of knowing what was in your heart when it stopped going. That is Robbie Williams, the elite person who's married the Williamses to Guy Innes-Ker, yeah, singing the song about the death of Elvis Presley. Yeah, what did we just say? Age 42. Yeah, and all of it is because his life is totally trivial. But because he's in these families, he's pushed into the public eye, like Christopher Martin and all of the Mayflower sailors. Yeah, and that is the religious profiteering that means that we're not allowed to love our neighbour as the false Jesus declared we should do. Yeah, or even pay any attention to the marital oath or any of the oaths that are signed, yeah, under the face of milud in the law courts. Yeah, that is the joke about the lawyers and the stealing of God's roles in bringing about justice on our world. I still believe that God is perfectly in control of that, and all of them will find it out in the next fortnight. Right then, so that's ELVIS, related to George W. Bush, seven of the Pilgrim families. Yeah, and the next generation after the Pilgrim winter in the first 2 years in America, yeah, all of them are no longer listed as Pilgrim fathers, because it's the children of them that are related to ELVIS. Yeah, and Michael Ancrum and Guy Innes-Ker and all of the people that I'm going to depict in these images. Yeah, that's the Hopkins family. That is the actor Anthony Hopkins. He played the captain of the Mayflower in the BBC movie. And it has the word Piso in it. There is where Andrew Kerr of Cessford lived, right up in the town of Moorbattle, which is a telling thing. There is Michael Ancrum, yeah, of the neighbouring region. Yeah, this is right up where the Vesties live, and the Muirdachs and all of the Murrays are related to the Dutch Duke and Duchess and Earls of Sutherland, where Madonna was married for a laugh. Yeah, because she's in the same world-owning bloodlines. Okay? 1450 by Andrew Kerr, ancestor of Robert Kerr, 1st Earl of Roxburgh, an ancestor of the Dukes of Roxburgh, yeah, who were sailing, yeah, into America and were providing all of the 600 elite families, all of which, yeah, according to my new informant in America, are super elite families related to kings and queens and claimants all over Europe. Yeah, do you get the sun god joke for Michael Ancrum in Ferniehirst? Yeah, which is that one. Yeah, right up on top of the Carter Bar, next to the Vesties property, and that's the Vesties that own Argentina and Australia and all of its butchery meat. Masters of the horse, like Michael Ancrum, yeah, that is the care of Ferniehirst. I think the next one is Ferniehirst. Yeah, this is the secret castles right on the Scottish border, care of Ferniehirst. Robert, that was not a care. Earl of Somerset. Ah, the Countess of Somerset. I met Somerset citizens on the River Teviot the other day. Very charming people. Yeah, and when I told them they would have to pay a toll to pass me by, they cottoned on really quickly as entrepreneurs, and the two of them asked me for a toll as I passed them by further upriver. Yeah, massive jokes about entrepreneurial tendencies, and all of them are thieves from the religion. Yet Michael Ancrum is related to the Masters of the Horse in Norfolk, and that is the next slide, I think. Okay, there's Michael Ancrum. Yeah, he's got all sorts of obfuscation tools. He's the one that brought down the Chinook. He's in the Secret Services Society. That means that even if you bring down the Chinook and kill all 29 of those people, that is a complete breach of military protocol, that you have more than two commanding officers on the same vessel or vehicle. Yeah, he's now got black men to cover up his identity. There he is, yeah, in the House of Lords. He's no longer in politics. I met him in the flesh, very penitent then, but he's clearly forgotten all of his sins and forgotten that it might be nice to get to heaven after all. Yeah, not one of those, only two of them, or Michael Ancrum. Yeah, and that is him talking to the false press men in Britain. Next one. Arundel Cathedral. They have massive shareholding scams out of Arundel Cathedral. I've made two or three videos on it. There is the links to the Dukes of Norfolk. That is Howard, friend of the man for all seasons, that is Thomas Moore, and his bloodline are in the ELVIS bloodline too. Yeah, it's ever so funny There is the tits out now, that is the only tool that they can deploy. Yeah, and there's the beheading of a couple of queens because of this massive religious joke. Yeah, that if we continue to divide and conquer, we can keep the numbers down and we can take all of the profits for ourselves. And there is the Christian cross coming tumbling off in the Latin America, and that is the joke about Bungie being the god of sky in Australia for Rupert Murdoch. Yeah, that is when they had me sectioned, when I wrote to David Cameron and the Queen in the same week. I wrote to Guy Innes-Ker, all of them were recipients of that email, all of them are now complicit in all of the crimes that I still continue to report. Yeah, and only the people in gala shields have given me their identity. That is PC Changeling and PC, I forget the other one, yeah, but they signed for all of my disclosures to Theresa May, and all of those disclosures have been reposted on Facebook again this morning. Okay, with the crimes of the Bank of England and their interlocks to the Forbes rich list felons in China, that is the Kwok family. Yeah, interlocking with the new boss at the Bank of England. Yet since I revealed David Lees, yeah, Dave Prentice, the leading union leader, is still on the court. So there's Colin Cowdery in Longshanks bloodline. There is Howard of Norfolk. And there is the cathedral at Norfolk, yeah, which they have released shares from to profit from the false Jesus story. And that is Russell Grant, who still, right up to the moment that she falsified her separation date, yeah, to get divorced in the first place, he was sending her his Reading the Future things all over the world. Yeah, I've got everything that they have shared with me. Yeah, because our email address in New Zealand, was it the same one? Right then. So, next picture. There is CARE again. Every one of her employees and employers all across the world. This one lived in Grantmans Bay, where we went for our last holiday together. Yeah, I disclosed more healthcare frauds there involving the Irish doctors that lived in bigger and bigger houses as they moved up the food chain. And eventually we went for coffee where Ang Yang Sao Ki, the Burmese false news person, actually lived in a safe house, yet owned by that medic. Yeah, from Ireland. He does not reply to any of my queries now, like Dr. Stephen Andrew Hancock's and all of his dental cabal. None of them are left on Facebook because it's too risky to risk my disclosures. Okay, so this one is in charge as an unelected officer. He's formerly the boss at Imperial College London, immediately after Manningham Buller, the war criminal. Yeah, head of MI6. Employer of my wife's colleagues at Otago Poly. Right then, and she declared that to me, and they're all in the pictures about Butlins, and all of my employers, yeah, that is the University of Sunderland and everything that's happened to me. None of my students now talk to me, Adam Errington, yeah, my loyal subjects. Right then, next picture. Do you get the linkage to CARE now? Yeah, and my postman for a long time, and even my girlfriend for a while, was Thora CARE. That is the Thor joke. Yeah, it's the CARES that are the jewellers in town, like the Blairs in town and the former owners of this house. Okay, this one is in charge of the dismemberment of the EU, the launch of Brexit, and his colleague is also the unelected Tony Blair. I don't think he's a jeweller, but he's got loads of dosh because of everything that they have done, yeah, as Labour Party leaders to the brutalised world since 2004, when we got on the plane to New Zealand. And I've become ever such an honest man ever since, and my truths are the telling truths that will bring this lot down. Okay, Brexit is his plan. Yet none of their plan on the European cabal that he chairs is published in English on Wikipedia. It's all published in French because they're totally ashamed of it. And he lived in Granton-on-Spey, where that corrupted doctor lived. Yeah, really nice doctor. He gave my kids waders so they would not have to suffer in the freezing River Spey. That is Granton-on-Spey, where we went for holidays every year with my best man, who's been hit by lightning twice because he's a total traitor. When I went into the pub last night, I heard them murmuring, "Here's the zany Professor George Lees again." Yeah, or the loony Professor George Lees. When I went back later on, all of them had disappeared. Yeah, and that's the people that own the fishing huts that have been swamped and swept out to sea. Okay, so there is Granton-on-Spey. Every year I used to go there with that best man and with my wife. Yeah, yeah, total treason. And our last holiday was in 2012, and it was coincident with the war crimes jokes of the 2012 London Olympics. Mr. Bean was the war correspondent for Gallipoli, and everyone now knows that. That's why all of the information on Quentin Bryce, who revealed it to me, has been taken down off the internet, and the videos have been taken down off my own website by Google, which is run by Jimmy Wales, who's in the tax havens with Sean Connery and the people you see in one of the later images. This is the millionaire that now lives in Granton-on-Spey. He's the one that was alleged to have defrauded Rangers. His big boss at Rangers is Sir David Murray, who's a friend of the regime at the SNP, yeah, which is Alex Salomon Rothschild. And there's a salmon in the Bank of England now, and I'm going to reveal him later on in the images. Okay, so this is Craig White, 5 million mansion in Granton-on-Spey, and that is his residence in Monaco. Yeah, and all of the supporters, yeah, have to live in the debt pools. They have to be arrested for being in arrears on their payments for their rented homes. Yeah, and all of those that are in marriages can get them ripped apart using these Freemasonic tools. Yeah, like Mrs. Valerie Jane Lees, nay Hancocks. And the Hancocks are the owners of Rio Tinto. Yeah, and they are the people that I wrote to Theresa May about. Yeah, that is now the widow of the Hancocks, who is Gina Reinhart, and she's orca fat like my wife. Okay, I must not call her my wife now because I'm totally ashamed of her. And she chooses to live in my home country so she can get those kids a free education, in inverted commas. Yeah, that is David Cameron's sign. That is David Cameron's greatest achievement. Yeah, gay marriage and stealing from all of the British students £70,000 for the honours degree he got for free. This one is the salmon at the Bank of England. Yeah, they issue money, they make speeches, and all of it goes into their own pockets and their own suitcases. And he was trained at the Bank of England, where Theresa May worked for a full decade. He has worked there for 20 years, and he was trained by Mervyn King, the former boss, who interlocks with the Rothschilds every which way up. Yeah, and all of that is in the videos that John Patterson and I have made on, I forget what his alternative names are, because none of them dare use the real names. I've been looking for him all morning. He does not have any holdings that you can detect on the first 40 pages. Yeah, I forget what his first name is. I think it's Christopher. Yeah, the religious fraud is everywhere. Next one is Mervyn King, yeah, and all of the covers for it now. Yeah, you've got darts cover, you've got a bowls cover, you've got Andy Hamilton darts, Mark Carney, his successor, 800 grand a year on the board. Yeah, when you look at the accounts for the Bank of England, they declare that the top executive only gets 270,000. It's a total lie. Yeah, and this one is a multi-billionaire, because he trains everybody else in Basel at the Bank of International Settlements, and he lived in Petit France near Watford, and my wife used to go there because she's an Enid Blyton fan, and that's where the Enid Blyton Museum is, and that is the famous fucking five joke for Rothschild. Next one is High Keith, the High Marischals, that are the Keiths of Scotland. Never heard of them till last night. Loads and loads of them, generation after generation, like Michael Ancram and the Marquesses of Lothian, linked into the Germans through the Schoenberg linkage. Yeah, and that is the linkages to the Duchess of Sutherland, who is, after all of this time, I've revealed it now. Let me show you the... No, let's get the pictures out of the way. Okay, Howard, a man for all seasons. So Michael Ancram's wife is a Duchess of Norfolk. She's really sick at the moment, or she was the last time I saw her. Yeah, but at least they have the courage to come and talk to me. Yeah, but not since I revealed that he was the Secretary of State for Ireland since the Chinook crashed. And I made the video, and when I went to visit his house without declaring anything, they came down to meet me in the garden as if they have surveillance tools all over their estate, which is massive and totally undisclosed. It cannot be found on Google Maps. The Fairnehurst site that you've seen, that is linked to the Pilgrim Fathers and everybody that sailed in those 600 elites in the first few ships, yeah, that is a different place. It's on the Scottish-English border, right next to the Vesties. Okay, and there's the man for all seasons. So he's Howard, Sir Thomas Moore's friend. And guess what? The Schofields are in, yeah, the same bloodlines as Elvis. Yeah, there he is. Schofield, Thomas Moore. They interlock, yeah, familiarly to Elvis Presley's family, to George W. Bush's family, to Franklin D. Roosevelt's family, that are the Murrays of Selkirk, Fala and Philip Hawke, which is David Steele's, yeah, crime scene. The boss at the Scottish government, yeah, when I first arrived home, defrauded the Scottish government by taking the budget for its buildings up tenfold. Yeah, on the same boards as the Fleming thieves and the mass murderers in wartime. That is the Scottish widow's joke in financial services. And Ian Fleming interlocks with all sorts of lords and ladies. Yeah, and he interlocks with Sir David Steele of Akewood, which is right next door to the Selkirk Cemetery, where FDR's relatives are buried. That's the Murrays, the outlaws of Scottish freedom. Yeah, they're on the tabs if I get to them. Okay, I like to keep it simple and show you the pictures. Yeah, that's why Stephen Andrew Hancock's does not like to get publicity anymore. Okay, there is the Kimballs that are in the Fugitive movie. That is Richard Kimball, yeah, who's alleged to have murdered his wife in their stitched up case. That is him when he goes to find the evidence and presents it all, that he is the innocent and law enforcement are the guilty party. Yeah, and all of the pharma profiteers, Dr. Fingland, yeah, get what they deserve in the end. Yeah, so the Kimballs are in the bloodlines for Elvis Presley too, spelt slightly differently. Yeah, isn't it funny? This woman is in it too. Oh no, this is Bill Gates. Oh, I might have forgotten to put the woman in. Yeah, I forgot to put the woman in. Anne Bancroft, yeah, who is Mrs. Robinson with the suspenders, is in the same bloodline as Elvis. Yeah, do you remember that movie with Dustin Hoffman? Yeah, and all of the jokes about Dustin Hoffman the Freemason being in all of those movies. Yeah, and that is the movie that I love, because it shows you how detailed investigators can be when you see Dustin Hoffman playing the role of Charlie Babbitt in that where scene where he counts the toothpicks on the floor. Yeah, and he gets it right but misses four, and the four that he missed are still in the box. Yeah, like every crime that I solve, no one pays any fucking attention to it. But thank you to the employees of Scott and Company for looking really alarmed about everything that I told you about how our government is totally corrupted and all of its law firms are money launderers. Yeah, so there's Bill Gates, and he is related to someone who's coming up next, I think, and that will be Stephen House. Oh no. So this is Dr. Stephen Andrew Hancock's again. There's his check. There's the arsenal jokes for the Hancock's family. The arsenal, yet, is an Egyptian pharaoh that is in the same bloodline and descended from Lagos the Rabbit of Macedonia and Alexander the Great. And arsenal, yeah, is the arsenal joke, and that's why the arsenal players have the pie pineapple on the head. Yeah? Okay? And that's what's going to bring him down. Yeah? Posted on his own website, yeah, under the name that got. Yeah, as soon as I started to find these people on Skype, our mate that launched all of the Eurovision Song Contest, he died really quickly. I forget his name now. He's my greatest hero on the radio in the morning. The Irishman who was surgical stockings in his jokes. Okay, and there's FDI, World Dental Press Limited, all of them stealing from the whole of their profession. Yeah, and all of the dentists that lived in Preston, the Piso word in it, yeah, were the Cahills, and that is the Calvary Hill jokes. All of them have dropped out. All of the Cahills in Intel have dropped out because that is the Calvary Hill joke about Jesus who never fucking lived. Yeah, and there's Valerie Jane Lees on my Facebook page with her dark glasses on. Yeah. And so the rest of it is non-entities. There's Stoat on the Wold and the massive Christian versus Christian massacres that occurred in David Cameron's constituency when they were bringing in the Orange leaders to replace the Roman Catholics. Yeah, and that becomes the Hungerford Massacre. So what we've missed is Mrs. Robinson with her suspendies on. Yeah, she is in the bloodline that is Elvis and George Bush's. There she is. Okay, the Graduate movie. There's her stockings, there's her attempt to seduce him, and there she is with the British American Tobacco cigarette icon. So the Bancrofts are in the family that is Elvis Presley, George Bush, yeah, and the Kerrs from Scotland. Quite exciting, Michael Ancram, don't you think? To be secretly, yeah, such a murderous person for all of your life in the House of Lords, when you send all of NATO's armies to their death out of your constituency near the south coast of England, where all of the Victorian crimes occurred. Yeah, that's the Bretts of Esher and all of Michael Ancram's constituency in Devizes. He's now been replaced by a Perry. The Perrys were also in the Mayflower passenger list. Yeah, and that is Katy Perry, and it is the new MP for Devizes, where NATO's armies still get trained, yeah, by Michael Ancram's successor as soon as I began to dog on him. And he panicked quite a lot, which is why he's been replaced by all of those black men on Google Images. Right then, do you get it? Let me now tell you the stories about the Scottish treason. So there you've seen already how we get to Elvis Presley in the bloodlines. Let me take you to the bottom and show you how this links all of these elite families and the pilgrims to Hugh Capet of the Capet dynasty. Yeah, that is the Capets, and that is the Chicken Run movies, and all of the massive launch of the Moravian dynasties. And they in Moravia, which is across in Poland. Yeah, you remember the Polish death camp stories? Yeah, my mates called Clifford in the town. You remember those death camp stories that allow the Warner Brothers to get into America And these are all led as false religions, and guess what they're called? Pietists, because that is the piezo joke. Yeah? Right then, let me tell you about Outlaw Murray in the Scottish Borders. There's the tab. Okay, the history of the Royal Borough of Selkirk. This is Andy Murray, David Murray, and all of the false news. It is Alan Murray and all of the people that used to be my friends and my colleagues. Yeah, they're totally asset stripping our country. They run the debt pools. Even in agriculture, they have no abattoirs in our region now, because all of that is commanded for them by Prince Philip, the massive asset stripping penniless person that came in from Greece under all of those false names. Yeah, he's now Mountbatten on Burke's peerage. Yeah, having murdered Mountbatten himself, using MI6 and the IRA as the cover for that. The incident of the outlaw Murray refusing homage to the king, but finally giving way on being installed as Sheriff of Ettrick Forest. They have claimed that William Wallace was the guerrilla warfare expert in Ettrick Forest. All of these could be Freemasonic jokes, but it ties you into the massive Dukes of Buccleuch and all of the estates that I have worked on for a pittance. Yeah? Has long been considered by many to be merely picturesque legend perpetuated by the well-known ballads of Sir Walter Scott, who's so evil that his bloodline has totally died out. Pippa, don't know who funds your wages now. However, eminent Scottish authorities now accept it as a historical fact. It is known that John Murray, mentioned as the Queen's herdsman in Ettrick Forest in 1460, yeah, that is 30 years after the religious war that is the 30 years war all across Europe. No, it's not. It started in, sorry, we're in the wrong century. It's the 17th century is when the Pilgrim Fathers sailed. Okay, Philip Hawk is where David Steele, look at my video on the cemetery in Selkirk and you'll see FDR, David Steele and the bandits of that region are totally ruthless. FDR is the most ruthless of the lot because he killed 45 million people with his Pearl Harbor joke, and he lives in fucking Oyster Bay. Yeah, and his relative is Teddy Roosevelt, and he murdered the incumbent president when he was shooting bears in the woods for the Rothschild affiliation. The Murrays of Philip Hawk were certainly sheriffs of the forest before 1503. Kevin Drummond, who has placed a lifelong gagging order on me talking to any of the corrupted judiciary, is the sheriff of Selkirk, and he is the three arrows for Rothschild fraudster. And look that up on the internet and you'll find Sir David Steele, the Scottish thief from Philip Hawk. Yeah, Sir David Steele of Akewood, he got the public to fund the rebuilding of his keep tower and he runs NHS frauds from it. And I've got the pictures of all the cardboard boxes in his massive double-doored garage. Next, Flodden, the departure and return. 800 went from Selkirk to Flodden, and I'll play you those if I get a chance. That's the Murray Jeans tab. Let me quickly show you how false religion has transited from the Polish death camps. Yeah, in that, what did we have? We had 1500s here, 1461. So all of that religion that is the Moravian, yet Pietist religion, has come right across, and there are now 500,000 Moravian church worshippers in corrupted America. It might be better to show you the sad, sad history of Selkirk, because I want them all to have a conscience. That is where they took me. They dumped me on the street, and that was the company that came and threatened me again this morning. 20 miles from my home, they dumped me on the street, telling me that they were going to take that home from me. and this morning it was announced that that will happen in the next fortnight. So let me show you how the leaders of men lead their people to massacres. Okay. Oh, this might get too many tabs open. Okay, this is the departure and return of only one man to the battle of Flodden. Do you get it? That is the floods and Odin. Yeah? And Cull Odin is an even more vicious joke against gods. Okay? And that is the, all the poets that they write, poems that they write. And Michael Moore, you can see him making a fool of himself, because what they sing about is that the combatants in those battles who all die weed their pants. Yeah, I'll show you the lyrics. It might have been on that last tab, the Battle of Flodden. And here is Fletcher. Fletcher was on the Mayflower too, after the Battle of Flodden. He's the only one of 800 who returned. Can you guess that the double agents get a special deal? Yeah, and that is him finding a pregnant woman at the foot of the tree. Yeah, and there's the flowers of the forest song. Yeah, all of them, the kilties all over the globe, are the joke about men in skirts. I heard them lilting, you milking, but the flowers of the forest are all weed away. That is the peasel joke for every great conflict that is engineered by religious and political and monarchy divine. The flowers of the forest are all weed away. Yeah, the peasel pistache, all weed away. And Michael Moore sang that, yeah, as he was refusing to meet me, just at the same time as he was being booted out of the cabinet, yeah, with nothing on Hansard since 2005, yeah, as the Secretary of State for Scotland. And it is a piss take about Scottish citizens and the kilties in particular. And when you get into the Tyrol, that is the Scottish soldier's joke. Okay, let me take you from there to the tragic story of how the Murrays, that are the bandits, begin to become the landowners, the Royal Borough Charter. Yeah, and all of them dress up and celebrate all of this treason through all of their lives. Yeah, and they dance and sing and get pissed as farts. Yeah, in as they ride the marches, in the joke that we are in control of nothing and we're quite happy to kowtow to the monarchy that is in control of everything. Okay, it's stopped there. I think the website must have closed me down. Oh no, the history of the Royal Borough of Selkirk. So that is not what I was reading in my bed at 4 o'clock this morning. Yeah, the common riding, let me show you how pathetic it is. Everybody's got ribbons. Ah, yeah, all of it has been changed since last night. His finest hour, 1998, standard bearer Alan Brown, casting the colours, my best man's name, the bronze and all the treason. And the Browns that played rugby for Stuart's Melville that still live in the Philip Hawk region and saw me working for £30 a day waved merrily at us as they came and visited me in New Zealand when I was earning $100,000 a year. And my wife was quite happy, yet with everything I did at that time. My research then was totally meaningless. Yeah? It's only saved a few lives. I'm going to bring everybody out of that debt pool, and I've got many of the students on my side, and the youngsters are the most eager to learn. Yeah? There are no youngsters in the Hancock's family. Right then. Yeah, they're totally childless. Three massive mansions, one in Chippenorton, yeah, one in Stoke-on-the-Wold, yeah, and one in Dunstew, yeah, where all of the registrations are recorded and logged by me. And began to break my wife's campaign apart when I started to cite them to everybody and sundry. Right then, we've not got what I wanted there to show you how the common riding, so that's them waving the flag. Yeah, that is the Saltire flag, that is the false religion joke that those are the cross keys icon for the Cluny Abbey in France, and all the border masons celebrate and invite to the rugby tournaments the Clermont-Ferrand rugby teams, yeah, and that is the global Freemasonry that kills all of the people, even at Culloden. Yeah? 1715, 1745, the Murrays are right in the leadership team fighting on behalf of the monarchs in England and dying at the likes of the Battle of Pinkie on the Lothian coast, where Archbishop O'Brien, "We worship you, O'Brien," is the false religion joke, never threatened by any law enforcement history. Yeah, I will cite that at the court, and it will allow them to understand the Piso Pietist joke that is the launch of the Moravians, yeah, and that is the Murdachs that are appear, yeah, back up in Sutherland. The Duchess of Sutherland is the bitch that sent them all to the colonies in the first place. Yeah, and that is the Murdachs that we're now learning about being the outlaws of Murray of Fala, and the Fala, FDR's dog, was called Fala. Yeah, do you get it? The Fala estate has been totally blown up and flattened. It's right next door to where I worked as a beater for the Duke of Northumberland, that is Perseus in the Roman court. Yeah, and on the last time I went there, I was a beater that they put me in a car that the dogs had shit in. Yeah, and that is all my friends in life. Yeah, that is young Murray, that is still my Facebook friend, and his mate that is Thornton. Yeah, that is the Thor jokes about displacing the gods. He had a massive accident and he's got half his brain cut out. But he's still driving lorries as a profession. Yeah, and he nearly killed his mate Murray in that car crash. And all of them drink in Lauder, and all of it is just Scottish treason. Yeah, the Brookses are in Lauder too. Yeah, that's the Brookses of Colditz and their relatives. Yeah, total profiteers. Fleshers and weavers, Henderson family in Melrose. Right then, so let's get back to the tabs and see what else we can disclose. I'll show you the Pietists. So here, these are the things that are cited. John de Moravia is cited on FDR's picture at Selkirk Graveyard, and here's all the links. So it takes you even into in Moravia, in this bloodline that becomes the Dukes and Duchess and Earls of Sutherland, you've got one called Jobs. Yeah, do you get it? All of the rich people are now able to account for. That's Jobst of Moravia, Wikipedia, the free encyclopedia. Jobst of Moravia, yeah. I think Bill Jobs was about 10th on the rich list. Yeah, he's also a computing magnate. A member of the House of Luxembourg, was Margrave of Moravia from 1375. Jobst was presumably born in 1354 in the Moravian residence of Brunnow, the Brotherhood Duke, the eldest son of Margrave John Henry, younger brother of CS1, German language sources, articles containing Czech's language text. Okay? So that's a whole list of the 6th Earl of Sutherland, the 5th Earl of Sutherland, the 4th Earl of Sutherland, the 3rd Earl of Sutherland, and that is the Andrews of Murray. Yeah, do you get it? The Murrays are all over it. That is the sectarian religion that is Protestantism. It is called all sorts of things, and my doctor that brought me into the world was Dr. Knox. Next up, Jobst of Moravia, let me show you. Doesn't look at all like Bill, he's a lot healthier looking. Yeah, Bill died really young because he made that joke that he was God's loyal servant in the Bible. That is the chapter Job, yeah, and the quotation that he was God's loyal servant until the devil came in and interrupted their dialogue. Yeah, he's got the bunny ears for Walt Disney. Yeah, do you get it? Bill jobs everyone on Forbes rich list. Is interlocking with the Bank of England. Yeah, and interlocking with all of their covers. Yeah, who are just false news, but are also billionaires themselves. That is the stories I've told you about Kaching in China, and Shania Twain's covers, and all of the things about Mammy Hans Rosling, and 85-year-old Rosling being the Swedish billionaire in frauds. None of the Rothschilds get a mention. And they are Jews for anti-Semitic reasons, and it's a nice way of earning loads of recognition in the inquests, which he totally run and totally stage. John de Moravia, 8th Earl. Okay? The Moravian religion is got 500,000 Yanks in it now. John de Moravia, 8th Earl of Sutherland. Yeah? Was the 8th Earl and chief of Clan Sutherland. During his... Yeah, that's the Williamses that were the Fishers at Aylesbury Rugby Club that still go to Sutherland every year. Yeah, and that is the Williams lineage that are married to Guy Innes-Ker in that massive castle that is floors the joke about the worktops. Yeah, for the Piso family. Earl of Ross and Lord of the Isles, and had the following children. John de Moravia, 9th Earl of Sutherland, died 1514. Yeah, so the pilgrims sailed 1620. Yeah, and the massive 30 Years' War occurred in 16... I think it was either 1618 or 1622. There was 2 years difference. Alexander de Moravia died young. Yeah, God is in control of a lot of that. If it's, yeah, a natural cause. Elizabeth de Moravia, 10th Countess of Sutherland, successor of her elder brother John, she married the Gordons, a younger son of George Gordon, 2nd Earl of Huntly. Yeah, which when we went there, yeah, in our Highland holidays, had massive floods too. Yeah, that's the Clan Gordons that have that black watch tartan that is used by the Melrose School and all of the profiteers like Lord Sanderson Abowden down here and all of the Masons in the Lodge and the Speculative Society in Edinburgh. Yeah, almost everyone in these stories and these families is in the Speculative Society. Yeah, and that was what linked me into Donald Trump's crimes out of America in wind power using Dunwilko Ponzi's in Scotland. And all of it is turned on its head in the false news they release. Alexander Sutherland, and there's Balnagown Castle. So we've got the Rosses, the Sutherlands, and Balnagown, never heard of it, Killifida, and the Mackays are in it again. Every time I find them out, they come drifting past. And the Battle of Turin Dub, that is Black Turin. Yeah, these are the Jewish labels already being applied to Rupert Murdoch's Jewish operations in Sutherland. They're the Muir Dacs up there when they come back. Right then. So, John 7th Earl. We've seen the Outlaw Murray tab. Here's the 7th Earl. This is another set of locations. Bailey of Lamington. They had 4 sons. Alexander de Moravia, Master of Sutherland. Now the Lamington thing takes you into the monuments, I think. Yet for the massive worms that are the death threats to all of the simple people. Yeah, and that is the Sunderland joke. Yeah, that is Kate Middleton's family right next door to Sunderland, County Durham. Yeah, and the massive, I forget what the Lambeth worm. Yeah, but this time we've got John de Moravia and we've got the Beggs of Otago. Yeah, the Beggs are in the world owning bloodline like the Capets. Yeah, and like all of the Moravian and Carolingian master race that run the world and run all of the genocides all across the countries that they expand by genocide. Next, Outlaw Murray, I think we've seen it. Murray of Philip Hawk and Fala. Okay, this is another wet. So there's Philip Hawk, that's how you spell it. That is where Steel of Akewood lives. That is where the massive castle is for the Duke of Buccleuch, that is totally empty and is only a tourist exhibit because they've got so much real estate that they cannot live in it all. Yeah, and that's where I used to fish. Yeah, and there's the Fala Hill joke, which is up nearer to the Edinburgh region, yeah, just to the north of Lauder. Yeah, the A68, Roman courts, all of it on the crime scenes that were the Roman road and the false religion. Right then, Philip Haw history. So, this is a little bit more detailed. That's where I used to go fishing. Yeah, that is where my visitors in New Zealand, they and I bought their car when I came back from New Zealand. I can't keep it on the road. Yeah, they visited me in New Zealand. They are Stuart's Melville players, and that is the Brewsters of the Mayflower. Yeah, and my dad's best mates. Yeah, and a tennis player for a laugh in Scotland. And this is the sadly, is the joke that these people are related to Catherine Hepburn, who plays Queen Mary. Yeah, in all the Hollywood movies. Do you remember Catherine Hepburn? And all of the stuff that is on the front page of the papers this week is lying in winter and us not being able to live through the winter because of the healthcare cover being slightly fraudulent. Yeah, that's the lying in winter story that I've exposed, with all of the world owning bloodlines, and the woman that we've just mentioned plays Eleanor of Aquitaine in that sad, sad movie about you kill everything that moves, and we'll allow King John, the baddie in Robin Hood, to emerge as the world owning sire of the next member of the world owning bloodline that takes you to Bush and Elvis Presley. Yeah, it's beautiful. There are the Eildon Hills, yeah, and it looks as if there has been something ripped off the top of one of those. Yeah, I would not be at all surprised if there are seismic activities. When they built the lodge in Gala Shields in the 16th century, they had an earthquake force 5. Right then, and there's the Selkirk thing, where 1 in 800 return from the conflicts, and they celebrate that still, in that way, using the piezo horse, yeah, for the elite families to parade around and laugh at the killing of all of the poor families. And David Murray gets to do it at Ibrox, and he runs the golf course next to the Borders Council, who have the donkey in the field for Jesus, in the donkey sanctuary. Yeah, that's the piezo religious joke, that the donkey on Easter Sunday is Jesus himself. It's the Monty Python's joke that the donkey on his shoulder, when they get the stones to stone the people, is not very well today. And it's the donkey for Butlins from Hemel Hempstead, where my wife came from and trained, yeah, in stationery companies before she went to Marks and Spencer's and Intel with Stella Remington, who interlocks with the fraudulent Forbes Rich List member, who is Quok, yeah, and has been jailed as a felon. As his interlocks get higher and higher up the Bank of England profiteering team. Okay, the origin of which, Murray, a very common surname, has been explained. This is the Athol Castles and the Dukes and Duchesses of Blair Athol, and its location right next door to Glam's. And Murray, a surname, when me and my disloyal wife returned from that holiday in 2012 when the London Olympics jokes were happening, she got absolutely swamped in that region when she stepped out of the car. Yeah, massive downpour of rain on her. On account of the Murrays of Tully Barden, these are the ones that are in the Jacobite treason. Okay, I forget what their name was then, but we'll find it further down. They are linked into Bothwell and the Mary Queen of, yeah, and the tragedy is that they are related to that woman Hepburn, and that's further down the page. Yeah, and Aberkearney under the latter. Yeah, so look this up for yourself. This is Murray of Philiphaugh in Selkirkshire, Archibald de Moravia, mentioned in the Charchley of Newbottle. That is Dalkeith, it's Newbattle. That is also the home for the Dukes of Haddington, and that is the Dukes of Walter Scott, and all of the connections and the hyphenated names to the Dukes of Buccleuch that take you into Sarah Montgomery, yeah, in the BBC Radio 4 team, yeah, and the Bothwells. Okay, let me just do all of the tabs and we'll take you back to the bloodlines. It's much more interesting to look at the Ballop relations, don't you think? The Ballop in Scotland is your... There's John Murray of Fallahill. That is FDR's dog, a Scottish terrier, named Fala, on his lap through all of World War II and the killing of 45 million people, so that he can appear with his British American Tobacco cigarette holder at the cemetery gates in Selkirk, yeah, where only one in 800 returned from the great conflicts, because all of them fight for themselves, and all of the killing of their poor people, they don't give a monkey about. That went on right up to 1914, yeah, when people were allowed to enter into the school system and learn to read and write. That's what's going to bring them down. It's the Murray Ballads of Selkirk and Philiphaugh, written by the Walter Scott dynasty that is so evil that it is no longer alive. Apologies to the Scots of my estate. Yeah. It's just absolutely massive. Okay, Sir Walter Scott. Yeah. The Ballads of the Outlaw Murrays of Selkirk, written by him, the leading Freemason, and that is why David Cameron's son, who was called Ivanhoe, yeah, Ivan, died aged 10, totally dismembered at birth. Yarrow Water, all of it is the God in the heavens, Jehovah's Witnesses joke. Yeah, and Yarrow takes you right up into that valley where the massive Duke of Buccleuch house is, that is Bowhill, and that is the bow connection to the Rothschild arrows and to the court and to the Scottish country dancing, that is the land grabs of all of the elites who the king, yeah, is superior to. And because of the Scottish country dancing jokes, yeah, that's the Earl of Selkirk jokes, yeah, and them being homosexuals, they are not able to fight back, Dr. Stephen Andrew Hancock's, and all of their lands are taken from them. Right then, what else have we got? Bush, Churchill, FDR bloodline. So this is, I found it. Yeah, this is what I was dredging through, and suddenly it came up again and again and again. It comes up. President George Walker Bush, 1946. George Herbert Walker Bush, that is the Walker's Whiskey in Scotland, 1924. Prescott, Sheldon Bush. You get the naming of John Prescott for Tony Blair, yeah, and the deployment of him as the total tool, yeah, in that massive war criminal regime, all of which I've reported to Law Enforcement Scotland several times over, and I have receipts from the Justice Secretary, Michael Matheson, all of it totally ignored. And they're taking my home away in a fortnight. Hannah Ruck, yeah, that is the joke about a Wiedersehen pet, and the man from Bristol that was the wrestler, who's now dead. All of them get horrible cancers. Anne Marbury, Eleanor de Bohun, yeah, that's Germany again. And that's the Eleanor bloodlines that are world owners. And that is the woman that is Catherine Hepburn in the families for the Moravians of Fala, yeah, and of Selkirk. Princess Elizabeth Plantagenet and King Edward I Longshanks, Eleanor de Castile. That's not Eleanor of Aquitaine this time, yeah, but that is Edward de Longshanks that murdered all of those Scottish people. Thomas Duke of Gloucester, Chidley Coote, Alice Ann Phillips, yeah? And this is Sandy's joke. That is Emily Sandy's of Aberdeen. And all of her lovely music, I love it. Yeah. And because this is a black family, and when we get to the top you'll find that, Chidley Coot, Sir Eyre Coot, Sally, Jamaican slave, do you get Emily Sandy's joke now? Yeah, and about the persecution by people in uniform of Emily Sandy's. Yeah, and the electrocution and the torture methods that they use in her videos. Sally, Jamaican slave, not even given a surname. Married to Sir Eyre Coote. Luther Powell, Maud Ariel Mackay, and in 1937, Colin Powell, the Foreign Secretary, who preceded the Rice criminals, yeah, in the White House. And the Rices are all through the Bill Gates bloodline. Right then. Bush, Churchill, FDR bloodline. I think we've done that. Is that what we've just been looking at? And here's the Elvis stories. You've seen the pictures. I think we're going to run out of time in a moment. So you get it, the whole of World War II is a joke. There is the bloodline that leads to Elvis Aaron Presley, 35 to 77, entertainer. Okay, and what else have we got on the page? There's his images, yeah, all of the songs that I sing, and that one about there's no earthly way of knowing what was in their minds when their hearts stopped going is one of the best lyrics that I've ever heard. Yeah, that is about the warmongers that lead the world into these conflicts through all of their history, and it gets them the land and the reputations, yeah, as religious figureheads, Pietists, since the Roman court and King Herod was helping them write the Bible. And that is the Pietists that are the Piso family, that are the most murderous cause of death in world history. All religions were launched by them. Okay, the ancestor of the ancestry of Governor Howard Deed. And just by chance, when I went through it, you find Elvis is on it, and you find all seven of the Pilgrim Fathers and dozens of the surviving second generation of those terrible years for them when they had to rely on the Indians' treason against the other 499 nations of Indians that allowed them to keep alive and avoid starvation and freezing to death in the vicious winters that God gave them, like the winters that we got in Chipping Norton when we returned from New Zealand in 2009, when my wife was still loyal, in inverted commas. Okay, look up wargs at wargs.com and you will find these fascinating bloodlines. Okay, so this is Howard Brushdean of East Hampton, yeah, and he is a governor in East Hampton in New England, where the Pilgrims went. Okay, and that guy there is a genius, because he, like me, has memorized all of this and is able to replay it easily. Gary Boyd Roberts, he in the last video declared that there are 600 elite kings and queens families, yeah, and dukes and duchesses that went in the Mayflower sailings and all of the subsequent boats, and they become the world leaders. Yeah, that is the Dick Cheney jokes, all of the links to the jokers in the films about the Schindler, yeah, and that is Schindler, who's related to the Eisenhower family that are, yeah, it's all totally twisted. Okay, and they arrive in East Hampton, they arrive in New York, they arrive in all the places that are the biblical names and jokes, yeah, like that Yarrow joke, yeah, and there's the Cooks that are in the bloodline, the Maitlands, the Wiggleworths, yeah, the Deans, if we do that it will take ages, the Fahies, Henry Francis Cook, Francis D. Cook is the American ambassador, they're in running the ferry boat in Brooklyn for a laugh. Yeah, that is Brooklyn, that is the Innsbruck birthplace for Pope Benedict, Hitler Rothschild, and Arnie Schwarzenegger on the West Coast. Right, Selkirk history. Sad.